At this time, it is my honor to introduce President Dennis Pierce.
Good morning. Welcome, Teamsters. We will be following the order of business as found in the National Division Rules, Section 39 of the BLET bylaws. And I declare that we are now under order of business number one. Delegates, the meeting is now called to order without form. The formal opening will take place in a few moments. However, before we officially open the convention, will you please stand for the presentation of the colors and our national anthem? When we convened in Miami in 2001, fewer than 2 weeks had passed since the tragic and deadly attacks of 9/11. We continue to be at war when we convened in Las Vegas in 2006, in Reno in 2010, and again in this very room 4 years ago. And America's sons and daughters remain in harm's way as I speak. At this time, I ask that all of those in the convention hall who have family members in the military to please rise so we may salute you. Thank you. You may be seated. Now I would ask everyone in the room who is a veteran of the U.S. Armed Forces to stand so we may acknowledge your service. And finally, I'm sure you are aware of the mass shooting tragedy that occurred in this great city 1 year ago. It's now called Vegas Strong. I ask that everyone rise for a moment of silence in recognition of our delegates, officers, and guests who have a family member in the military and this industry who have made the ultimate sacrifice and for those whose lives were forever changed 1 year ago tonight. Thank you. I now call Brother Matt Parker, Chairman of the Nevada State Legislative Board, to the podium. Brother Parker will serve as our national chaplain for the convention and will offer the opening invocation. Please remain standing.
Morning, brothers and sisters.
I think perhaps it's
fitting to have a Nevadan here on the stage this morning to welcome you all to the 36th and greatest state here in the nation. In addition to having the honor of serving as national chaplain at this convention this year, I also have the privilege of serving as state legislative board chairman here in Nevada. In the course of doing my work for this brotherhood, I am often humbled. I'm humbled when my work finds me in the presence of our national officers and I see firsthand their dedication to working so hard and bringing about changes to make more positive the lives of the membership of this body. I'm humbled when my work brings me in the presence of our elected officials, whom sometimes we disagree with politically, but all of whom are great Nevadans, fascinating people from varied walks of lives, with whom the opportunity to engage in conversation often brings opportunities to learn new things. This morning, I'm humbled to be here at this podium as I look out at this room, in the hallways, and the rooms beyond, and see hundreds of brothers and sisters who have a belief and a love for this brotherhood that motivates them to be servants to the membership. It's moments like these that cause me to examine myself and think, do I measure up? While your dedication and willingness to make sacrifices to serve the membership of this body are both admirable and noble, they're also traits of living a godly life, as we see in the book of Mark, chapter 10, verse 45. Where Jesus says, "For even the Son of Man came not to be served, but to serve, and to give his life a ransom for many." Will you please join me in a word of prayer? Gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for gathering us here safely and in health to do the important work for our members that is laid before us. We ask that you be here with us during the coming days, that by your grace we find all our needs met, and that you bestow upon us the wisdom to make sound decisions on behalf of the membership that we represent here. For those of us who have left behind loved ones to be here, we ask that you keep them in your watch care until we are joined again with them at the end of this work. It's in your holy and precious name that we ask these things. Amen.